Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BioView Gaming, and today we are back in Animallica. So, the developers just published another update, yes, yet again. They are busy, these guys, right now. This one actually has some new stuff. So, first of all, they fixed the coins achievement, which was related to the new system with we have the coins here, or the gold coins end up down here instead of you having actual gold coins. They get added to this counter down here, and that kind of messed up the coin achievement, but they have fixed that now so that you can still get that achievement even though they get added down here. They also adjusted some prices, and then they slightly changed the system for placing items. I'm not sure what they changed there, but I'm sure we'll realize that over time. And then they added some new craftable items. For one, there's the gazebo, which is this one. Let's just place that down right there. Oh, if it's gonna let me. Okay. I see. Aha, so we get like a little circle thingy. That kind of shows it instead of instantaneously placing it. But okay, look at that. Nice. Ooh, I like this one. I can see some people making some awesome bases using this. And then you could maybe place a little furniture or something right there. And ooh, nice. I also think this would look really, really nice with the Asian themed building, maybe, or the, well, also the medieval, I think. Very nice. I like this one. That looks really, really pretty. Then there is this new water trough. Just pop you over here. Oh, right. I have to, now I have to get used to holding down the left click. I guess it's just because people sometimes, you know, happen to click and then suddenly they've placed it and then, you know, they have to use a hammer or some kind of tool to pick it up, and now it just takes a second longer to actually place it. Okay, so we have this new one, which has a new look. I kind of actually like this one. It has this like worn look, like many of the many of the pieces of furniture we have. So now we have three different water troughs. There's the small one, the large one, and then there's this one. Nice. Then they added something that we have been requested for a while. So, for the meat eaters like lions and tigers and so forth, or bears for instance. Well, bears can also eat fruit for instance, from what I know. But now we have one for fish, and we have another one here. Let's just pop that down for meat. So now we have raw meat and we have fish, so we can feed our lions and our bears. Nice. Okay, so these just take a little bit of raw meat, a little bit of raw fish, and then some aluminum ingots, or aluminium ingots, depending on where you are from and how you pronounce that. This one takes a water pump, and then I think maybe it was some nails or something and some timber. But yeah, pretty basic resources, all of it, and the same for the gazebo. I didn't have to go and farm anything. It was pretty normal. The only thing here is roof tiles, I think. That is the most rare thing. And then you need some green paint, which you can make in the art station, unless you find it somewhere as loot. Yeah, apart from that, it's not really anything that is hard to come by. So that was nice. We got some new stuff to play around with, those of us who like to build a base. There is also an oil lamp and a candlestick apparently, but I don't know if I'll have to go to the basic workshop and see if they added it there without adding it to the advanced workshop. So far anything in the basic workshop you have been able to also make in the advanced one. Because I haven't been able to locate any of these in any of these workstations, and I have like the blacksmith, the cannery, the kitchen, the advanced workshop, the garden shed. There's a laboratory. I haven't checked that one. I could check that one. There's the art station. There's the weaving hut. There's the carpentry And well, let's just in case, let's just check. Mutagen, I wouldn't expect it to be in here, but yeah, you never know. It depends on how it is made. Nope, not seeing anything. There we go. Nope, nothing. Okay, so either it's in the basic workshop, or they finally did a little bit of what I, for one, have been requesting and hoping for, that they would add some things that you can loot. Hopefully something unique. It doesn't have to be completely unique, but something that you can't just craft. It would be, oh, well, maybe they're actually at a trader.
Yeah.
Ooh, that might be the deal. Maybe we should go and check the traders. I haven't actually checked that. I think we're gonna try and do that. Okay, so I went and checked the traders, and I actually have a little comment. I mentioned in a previous episode that I felt like something had changed here, and yes, it actually has, because they have removed all of these except this last part here with the wooden pavement. There was actually wooden pavement going all the way down to the boat, which I think was new after 2.0 that they added wooden pavement here. But you can actually see it when you spawn into Corpse Harbor, when you take the teleport, when you look at the picture, you can see there's wooden pavement going all the way here, and that is what has changed, because I was like, there's something different here. And that is actually because it's missing, and apparently they chose to change it to this other texture. Which I wonder if this is something we are going to be able to do, if you prefer to not have an actual pavement to place down, like this one, or the stone ones, or the brick ones, then maybe we could kind of stamp the ground, so to speak. I don't know if it's something they intend on us to be able to do in the future, but we'll have to see. But what I came here for, there's an oil lamp. 120 gold coins. Light source, placing too many lights will affect performance. Yep, let's get one of those. Now I'm just buying one, I just want to see. And we have a candlestick. Yep, let's buy you. And since I'm here anyway, let's just, I don't want to say max because that will cost me all my gold. But we do get 20 each, so let's see if we buy. Yeah, that should be fine. That gives us 200 fillers. I do have some fillers at home, but yeah. Technically, I could probably just place this stuff here. Let's see. Ooh, got that. Okay, can I like... can I get you to place up here somehow? No, you don't want to do that? Ooh, come on. I want... ooh, ooh, nope. Okay, it doesn't really want to do that, but okay, this isn't really one of my placed items. But let's just see what it looks like. Oh, you don't... oh, that's because you're too close to me. Aha! Oh, I have to get used to this new thing. Ooh, look at that! We have a little oil lamp! How cozy is that? Nice! And you don't need anything to pick it up. You can just do this, so you can actually bring it with you if you just need to have a little light. It doesn't seem like you can, like, carry it like an actual light source, except for the torch. But look at that. Oh, that's a nice little one. Oh, I still have to play around with this to see if we can like get it to place on top of tables and stuff. That would be pretty cool. Okay, so that was the other two placed items. So we got in total 6 new placeable items. Very awesome. Then they added a new animal, which we're gonna go and check out, and there might be a good chance that we can find it based on the picture in the update. I don't know if it's kind of a little bit of a cheat, so it won't actually be where it shows it in the picture in the update. Those of you who are used to play this game, you will probably not have a hard time recognizing where that is. They also increased the size of bears and big cats. We could go and check that out. And then they have a new theme music for Burning Sands map, which I... Oh, there's another thing. Okay, let's just... I don't know, it's just a personal thing for me. I hate having stuff in my hands when I'm just running around, if I don't have to fight something or shoot something. But they fixed apparently the water mechanics, so So that when you couldn't breathe at the surface. So let's just see. Oh, look at that. It instantaneously disappeared. That little oxygen thing. Oh, that is so much easier than it was before. I actually tried to do this in last night's live stream. Well, I'm recording this on, well, Sunday night. Saturday night I was streaming. And I tried to get back up after showing the famous orca. And I just couldn't get my little lady here to actually drink. Oh, that is awesome. It's still a little bit tricky at some point, but yeah, a lot easier. Like, how many times did I do this? 4 or 5 times. And usually in the time span I was in that water, I wouldn't even have been able to, you know, get some air. It wasn't impossible before, but it was very, very tricky. So that is awesome. They fixed that. And then I noticed something. Okay, I'm probably gonna... Okay, because it seems like they have added colliders now, because you can actually walk into this guy, so I wonder if we can shoot him. But I am just gonna save, because I don't know if they're gonna shoot back, or if we can actually do anything with this, but I just wanna test this out. I have a feeling they're supposed to kind of protect the townspeople from bad guys. I don't know where this is gonna lead with these guys, what they have intended with them, but let's just try this out. There we go. Bugged out my stuff a little bit. Did it actually go through him or... No, look at that. Okay, we can make him look like a pincushion. Okay, so they don't really do anything yet, so they don't attack you. But at least now they have colliders on them, so you can actually shoot them. It looks a little strange, as if they're not really part of the world currently, which I don't think they are. It's more like a little hint on where we're going with this. So that's going to be interesting in the future. So what else do we have? That was the water system. Yes, let's try and go to Burning Sands. I can't actually remember the music here because it's been like a few months since I was here. And I think I've only been there a couple of times around the time when I was raiding the pyramid. But let's just go and take a little listen for anyone who can remember this, or just to, you know, hear what it sounds like. Okay. Do you hear any music? Not right now. Yeah, there is some music. Of course, I have a cat that had to scratch a kitty tree, and my PC is kind of going a little crazy right now. But there definitely is music playing. Can I actually turn this up in the settings? Music, yes. I know this is probably a little loud, but let's just... Well, it definitely fits, matches the theme of this with the pyramids and this kind of Egyptian theme, I guess. Mm-hmm. Okay, nice. I just wanted to give you guys a little listen to that. Probably, at least it doesn't sound like it's too repetitive. I'm like, the only biome where I'm like, I'm not a big fan of the music is in Damba. Not that I'm really, that I don't like the music. It just feels like it's like the same little piece playing over and over, which most of them Okay, let's see, now it changed. Nice. See, this is what I like. There's like different pieces of this piece of music. So it changes over time, and of course it will be the same thing like playing over and over, because if you're here for like, I don't know, spend like 5 hours in this biome, it's gonna be hard for them to have, you know, new music all the time. But in that bar it just seems a little too, I don't know, the same. We have a good word for that in Danish, but I don't know how to say it in English. But that's the only one where I'm kind of not a big fan of the music. So let's just see, I'm gonna turn this back down a little bit. There we go. I think that's fine. I remember having to turn this way down, way back in before 2.0, because apparently it was a little too loud in the videos, but it feels like they have lowered the music or something, because I rarely even notice the music, honestly. Okay, so what else did we have? We had this, the sheep that we need to go and check out, and the bears and big cats. Well, we could go and find a tiger. I might also leave that to you guys to find out yourselves, or we'll see. For those of you who don't play the game yet, you'll see when we get to some of these biomes that has tigers in them. But yeah, let's go and see if this sheep is actually where it indicates that it should be based on this picture. I have to go back there anyway to capture some very elusive hares that I failed to capture the last time I was here. Okay, let's see. We have the mill up here. Yeah, I still have that outpost over there that I need to take out. So this would be the place based on the picture. I did see something when I arrived here, but it seemed like it kind of... Oh, there they are. They're right over there. Look at that. Oh, that is awesome. Aha. Yeah, the picture is kind of taking from this side. It seems that one of them was here or something like that. If you look at the picture in the tree. Yep, let's see. Yeah, I think it's actually more or less right around here. But they are right over there, so let's see if we can actually get some of these. Which is typical, now I have to go through Green Hills again and see if there's more of them. And I have just more or less finished this biome going through it. Oh, there's more up there. Look at that. Wow. Okay. I'm happy I upgraded my bow, because it might end up getting pretty expensive in arrows. I don't know why some of them are kind of bouncing around like that, but okay. That's number two. Oh, okay, that one is gonna be tricky. I don't know if they're kind of registering me. Oh, okay, let's see if we can do this. Seriously? You're gonna make me waste all my arrows, aren't you? Okay, let's try this. Aha, got you. You have to time it right. Yep, okay, so 1, 2, 3, please. Oh, can I get my... No, it despawned. Okay, white face, that more sheep. Look at these. Nice, I love they added new animals. And yes, I know. I know a few people who really, really, really love the horses and can't wait to get more horse breeds. I would also like more horses, of course. I'm just happy when we get new animals. But it is also nice to see something other than horses, because we have several different ones now. And we even have the donkeys. So, yeah. I feel like we can wait a little bit with more horses and maybe get a few other animals. I, for one, am still waiting for the pandas. I'm so hoping we're gonna get pandas. We need pandas in Kitchenston, don't we? I so want pandas. But yeah, and I haven't been out there and checked, but for those of you who watched my last stream, did they go? Oh, they're not there. Okay, they're up there. I'm gonna go up and see if I can get some more of these. Or get them all, of course, because I'm me. But those of you who watched my last stream or the last video, of course, because I actually think, have I published? Yeah, I have published that, I think, maybe. I can't even remember, but I think I published it yesterday. But too many things going on at the moment. But I found one of these little purple mounds from before 2.2 that spawned four. Boars way out in that direction, and yes, annoyingly to some people probably, I reported it that it was there, and it should have been fixed now, so it shouldn't be there anymore. Which is something I'm gonna go and check, of course, just to give some feedback to the developers, but I don't need, you guys don't have to watch me go out there and check it out. And they also fixed, I had another little bug actually with my animal container back at my base. That was a single one that kept respawning every time I spawned back into the biome. And of course I'm gonna check that now when I go back and see if it is actually there, but that should also have been fixed. But that was just like little things that I have noticed, and as usual the developers jumped right onto it and made sure to fix it. So that's awesome. Okay, I get the idea with why they changed this now, the placing system, because now, like I said, you have to hold down your left mouse button for a while to place something. And those of you who've been watching my videos lately know that there was, which there isn't anymore, this little trick that you could, like, nerd pull, as I call it, because that's what we call it in 7 Days to Die, for instance. But you can't do this anymore. See? Because you have to wait for this. Yes, so there is no doing that anymore. Yep, okay. So we'll have to see if we can come up with some other tricks for this. Aha, they also changed this, so you can't use the sword anymore. So the box works as the same as other pieces of furniture, for instance, where you have to use the maul. You can use this, but it just doesn't do it as much damage as before. You can also see the pickaxe and the axe. It doesn't do a lot of damage, but if you have a maul on you, which I actually have right here, I forgot I still had this on me after showcasing the other stuff, you can see that goes a lot faster. But that is another little thing that they have changed, so there's no using this as a vantage point. That's the only thing. One thing is you can't use it as, you know, during combat to take out the outposts easier, or the nests, like I've been doing. But that is not the thing that I'm missing. The one thing I'm missing with it is that you can't, you know, use it the same way as before. Well, you can. You can still do, you know, it just takes longer. Of course, you can still do this. You can place it down and place another one over here, for instance. And then you have to jump up here, and of course you can place it. There we go. But you can imagine if you're in combat, that's not gonna be a lot of fun. And of course it's gonna take you a lot more boxes, but you can go up. Like, I was about to say that now we can't do that anymore, but we can if you want to go up and take some screenshots, which is what I sometimes use this for, or if you just want a nice vantage point, which was actually what made me realize why they have changed this with the combat. I wasn't trying to do any combat, actually. I wanted to see if I could spot the other one of these rabbits that I've been hunting. While doing that, I actually found two foxes that I had missed. I probably scared them off, but they were right over there, in that kind of a little behind that house over in the trees. And I caught one of these hares, I keep calling them rabbits, that was kind of being very elusive last time I was here. And now I'm trying to see if I can find the other one. I've kind of slept and been out farming some resources, but I don't think it has come back yet. I have a feeling they don't move that fast when they're coming back, because they're just kind of wandering slowly compared to when they're running off, then they're like speeding up really, really fast. No, but that was just a little thing I wanted to show you. I'm trying to see if it's down there. I might be too far away. I feel like there's something in the grass over there, but I'm not sure. It just feels like there is something moving on in the grass in that area. But it might just be the graphics. Anyway, that was a little detail, a little extra detail I noticed. So, yeah, thank you very much for watching. And as always, you take care and happy gaming.